Ready for a wild ride down memory lane? Forget the easy living and the slow pace. Cruise on out to Indian Dunes Racetrack and try to capture the past, going at about 100 miles an hour. The men of the Western Racing Association roll out their antique race cars for some serious competition. They're called midgets, the cars, not the drivers. And they are still as spry as they were 50 years ago. They might need a push start, but they can almost out-sprint the modern-day sprinters.
Those are the ones we drove in the old days. We didn't have cage roll bars and beautiful crash helmets and tear-off lenses and big tires and open tube rear ends. We had homemade ones. And every old race car in those days was made of metal, either aluminum or metal. So each race car had a history behind it. Today, you go and buy one from the speed shop, and if you bend it up, the fiberglass body, you run by another part and stick it on it. You don't have the old history involved in what they did in the old days. Well, part of it's a novel. We enjoy it. It's the old cars we used to run, and we find old friends that we'd lost years ago, forgotten about years ago in the grandstands at different towns that come down to watch us run and come down in the pits and reminisce about the old times in the late 30s and the 1940s.
The association is really a good old boys club. The rules are very strict. The cars must be real, restored antiques, and the drivers must be over 40 years old.
At 61, I'm next to the youngest of the drivers. Saturday night in Napa, California, we had a 77-year-old drove a midget and really went fast.
You can relate it to flying. It's, I don't know, it's just something that not too many people can do, and we can do it, and it's a little bit of freedom involved.
I think dirt track racing is declining in popularity, and because of the availability of tracks, for one thing, and it's nice to see and hear, especially hear some of the sounds and sights of the old-time racing.
So don't laugh at the older generation. They still have a lot of miles left on them before they reach the finish line.